Welcome to all. Today we will discuss about one of the important subject, introductory biology. The course code of this subject is AGRI 1007. Under this course, we will discuss about binomial nomenclature and classification. The objective of this course is to study about binomial nomenclature, and you will learn about the nomenclature and classification, and you will know how to identify a plant using different types of interpretation. We will start from history and development of plant taxonomy, how plant taxonomy was started. In the image, you will see a plant, and this plant is further divided into flowering and non-flowering group. The non-flowering, they further divided in the roots and no roots, that like moss, ferns, and flowering are monocots, dicots is also there. First, we will start in the introduction. Herbalist, those who will prepare the Ayurvedic medicine, and agriculturist, you are the agriculture student, so your main focus in the agriculture crops. Past knowledge on plants from generation to generation. So Theophrastus, a great philosopher and a scientist in 372 to 287 BC, the Greek philosopher scientist called the father of botany, placed this knowledge of plants on a scientific footing. In his inquiry into plants, he dealt with the plants at a large and attempted to arrange the plants in several groups. Plinii compiled a monumental work entitled Historia Naturalis, where he incorporated all information about plants gathered up to that time. Dioscorides was a contemporary of Pliny, and like him traveled a lot and gathered information about medicinal plant and compiled his book Materia Medica. By the end of 15th century, a few German herbalists contributed for the development of plant taxonomy. Otto Brufels published his book Herbarium Vivae Iocoenis in three volumes in 1530 to 1536 with good figures. Jorme Bock, 1498 to 1554, published his book New Kronenbuch with description of about 600 species of flowering plants and classified them in three major groups. These major groups are herbs, shrubs, and trees. Andriaca Cigalpinio, 1519-1563, also classified plants on the character of their habitat and habit. These are trees, shrubs, and herbs, but also took into account the characters of ovary, fruit, and seeds. Published in famous book De Plants in 16 volume, the first of which contained his principle of classification. John Ray is the one of the great scientists in 1727 to 1705. He is also contributed in nature of plants. John Ray, an English naturalist, was the first to recognize two major taxa of flowering plants with dicotyledons and monocotyledons. He divided plant kingdom into two groups. First is the herbi under herbs and arbori. The herbari were then divided into imperfecti and perfecti, which include cryptogams and second group, that is arbors, included most of the flowering plant. Similarly, perfecti were subdivided into dicotyledon and monocotyledons. Under dicotyledon, he classified 25 plants of his classes and 4 under monocotyledons, published in his book Historia Plantarum. Carl von Linnaeus, a Swedish naturalist, proposed this system of classification in his book Systema Naturae in 1735. He also used the character of stamens. The number of stamens distinguished the 20 classes in which he divided plants kingdom. He also used number of nature of carpels to distinguish the order, that is subdivision and class. He further binary system of nomenclature is also published in Species Plantarum in 1765. The modern taxonomists have agreed to consider the year 1753 as a starting point of nomenclature in Phanerogams, Pteridophyta, and Sphagnum. In his Philosophia Botanica, he laid down some principles which later formed the basis of International Code of Botanical Nomenclature, ICBN. Due to effort of Carl von Linnaeus, the study of botanical science entered in the modern age, and nowadays Linnaeus is called father of modern. There are three types of system of classification. First, artificial system of classification. Second, natural classification. Third is phylogenetic. So it is the earliest system of plant classification, system of Theophaster Dioscorides. It remains dominant from 300 BC up to 1830. It was based on one or a few easy observable characters of plants, such as habit, that is trees, shrubs, herbs, or floral characters, particularly the number of stamens and carpels. Such type of classification using some arbitrary or at least easily observable characters, often irrespective of their affinity, is called artificial. Sexual system of Linnaeus is a good example of artificial classification, which use only one attribute, that is the number of stamens, for grouping plant into 24 classes, as a result of which various unrelated taxa, which are not at all related, similar in one respect only, have been placed under this category. Natural system of plant classification. These system of classification are based upon overall resemblance, mostly in gross morphology, thus utilizing as many taxonomic character as possible to this group taxa. This classification proposed by John Ray, Bentham Hooker, were based on natural principles of plant classification. Phylogenetic system of plant classification. It is started in 1859, followed the publication of Origin of Species by Charles Darwin. They used as many taxonomic characters as possible in addition to phylogenetic, or you can say evolutionary or interpretations. These are expressed in the form of phylogenetic trees or shrubs, showing presumed evolution of groups. Classification proposed by Hutchinson, Takhtajan were based on phylogenetic principle of plant. The natural system are two-dimensional, based on the data available at any time, and is known as horizontal classification, wherever the addition of the third dimension, that is the past history or ancestral history, result in phylogenetic classification, also known as vertical classification or evolutionary classification. Linear system of classification. The outline of linear system of classification with 24 classes. It is based on the stamens. If flowers have the one stamen, two stamen, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, up to 20. He has given the a category like monandria, diandria, triandria, tetandria. Because if flowers have one stamen, then he will given the mono. Two have the di, tri had the three. So his classification is mainly based on the stamens. Only a linear system of classification. Polyandria flowers with more than 20 stamens are attached to the receptacle. Diandria stamens, didymus. Diandria means stamen tetradidymus. So he has given such kind of classification up to 24. Like cryptogamia, non-flowering plants like cryptogams, which include algae, fungi, mosses and ferns. And this classification has some merits and demerits. The merit of this classification is quick and easily identification because it is only based on the stamens. If you have the stamens, then you can easily say, yes, this plant belongs to this category. The demerits of this classification, the system are developed on difference rather than on similarity of sex organs. The closely related members go apart and the distantly related members become very close to each other. The gymnosperm were placed in the 14 class, Didymenia, along with Labiatae and angiosperm family, because there is this conflict because flowering plant and gymnosperm both cannot be come together. Monocotyledon, dicotyledon, and gymnosperm, that is phrenogamy plant, are not considered separately, should be considered separately, but because the classification is based only on the stamens. So thus it can be said that this classification is just like a dictionary where the words are arranged alphabetically without maintaining any relationship. So this is the drawback of this. Now George Bentham and Joseph Dalton Hooker, he is a great philosopher and scientist. He has given the classification, and this flowchart is briefly explained, that is kingdom Plantae. Under the kingdom Plantae, subkingdom, that is Cryptogamia, then Phanerogams, seed-bearing plant. Then it is further classified in a category of dicotyledons, monocotyledons, and gymnosperm. Then dicotyledon further subclass, that Polypteli, Gamipteli, Monoclemidae. Then these are further classified in a series. So Thelemiflora, Dasyflora, and Calceflora. And in gymnosperm, they have further divided into three family, Cycadaceae, Coniferaceae, and Nitiaceae. Simultaneously, monocotyledons were also classified in the seven series. So this is the beauty of this classification, such salient feature of Bentham and Hooker system. It is a classification in only the seed plants and phanerogams. They describe 97,205 species of seed plants belonging to 7,569 genera of 202 family, starting from Ranunculaceae up to Graminea. So he have covered almost all. They classified all the seed plant into three groups and classes, that is dicotyledons 165 family, gymnosperm 3 family, monocotyledon 34 family. They include disputed orders among ordinally anomaly which they could not place satisfactory. Monocotyledons were described after the dicotyledons. Then dicotyledons were divided into three divisions, that is polypteli, gamipteli, and monoclamidae, and 14 series. Each series again divided into cohorts, that is modern order, and cohorts into others orders, that is the modern family. The author did not mention anything about the origin of angiosperm. Creation of Dasyphlorae, a taxon not described by the earlier taxonomist. Among the monoclamidae, major taxa like the series were divided on the basis of terrestrial and aquatic habitat. Polypteli carries 82 family, 2610 genera, 31,874 species. Gamopteli carries 45 family, 2619 genera, and 34,556 species. Monoclamidae include 36 families, 801 genera, and 11,784 species. Similarly, monocotyledons consist 34 families, 1,495 genera, and 18,576 species. So he covers almost all the domain classification. This classification have some merits and demerits. This is a great natural system, its own kind. This is one of the suitable for all the practical purposes, especially for identification and description of plants. Beginning of the subclass of Polypteli with the cohort order Ranales, comprised of Ranunculaceae, and its allied natural order, that is the family. The dicotyledons are primitive than monocotyledons. They have studied the actual specimens available at that time and represented them in classification after careful comparative examination. But this class has some demerit. The classification is based on the assumption of consistency of species, hence closely related cohorts, order, and often widely separated. Authors were salient about polygyny and dicotyledons and monocotyledons and anomalous position of gymnosperm in between dicotyledons and monocotyledons. The author did not consider the phylogenetic relationship. Monocotyledons, they place Stimini and Orchidaceae at the very beginning, but these should not be regarded as primitive with so many advanced characteristics is also there. In the class monocotyledons, proper emphasis has not been given. The relative position of ovary, the characteristics of the perianth were also not given. Engler and Prentl system of classification. Adolf Engler 1844-1938 and Prentl 1849-1893 proposed the phylogenetic system of classification. According to this system, the families were arranged according to increasing complexity of the flowers, fruit, and seed development. The general outline of system proposed by Engler and Prentl. This system is mostly seed-bearing plants, then monoclamidae, monocotyledons, dicotyledons, and gymnosperm. Monocotyledons further divided into aclamidae and sempetalidae. Then monoclamidae, they have further divided into different order like pandanales, halobate, triuradials. So according to this system, the large artificial group of Bentham and system, the monoclamidae, has been completely abolished. The system of gymnosperm are treated separately. Sympetals of the system corresponds to the gamopetals of Bentham and Hooker system. They consider the orchids to be more highly evolved than the in this system, the MNT fairy और कैटकिन बियरर्स दैट इज द सेलिसिएसी जुगलेंडेसी बेटुलेसी हैव बीन रिगार्डेड एज मोस्ट प्रिमिटिव. द एक्सेप्टेंस ऑफ डेरिवेशन ऑफ डाइक्लेमाइडस फ्लावर डिडाइक्लेमस फ्लावर पेरियंट इन टू सीरीज फ्रॉम मोनोक्लेमाइडस वंस पेरियंट इन ए सिंगल सीरीज इज ऑब्जेक्टिव. In this system, monocots have been considered to be more primitive than dicots, which does not correspond to the present day knowledge. Derivation of bisexual flowers from unisexual. John Hutchinson system of classification. John Hutchinson, 1884 to 1972, an English botanist. Has given his latest information about phylogenetic classification of angiosperm, which have been published his famous book Families of Flowering Plants recently in 19. The following principles were adapted by Hutchinson to classify the flowering plant. These are the evolution takes place in both upward and downward direction. During evolution, all organs do not evolve at same time. Generally, evolution have been consistent. Trees and shrubs are more primitive than herbs in a group like genus or family. Trees and shrubs are primitive then. So, angiosperm further divided into dicotyledons, monocotyledons. Then it will come divided into division. The division that is leguminosity, that is wood habit, herbaceous. That is herbaceous habitat, calciferae or distinguished calyx and corolla, calciferae, calyx and corolla almost similar. So this is a kind of classification, and this classification have some merits and demerit. He divided the phylum angiosperm flowering plants into two subphyla, that is the dicotyledons and monocotyledons. The dicotyledons are further divided into two divisions, that is leguminosae arboreal and herbaceous, that is herbaceous. Leguminosae includes fundamentally the wood represented derivative derived from magnoliaceae and herbaceous, including most or the predominantly herbaceous families derived from Reynolds. The subphylum monocotyledons are derived into three divisions, that is calciferae, coronaliferae, and gloomiflorae. So in the latest system of Hutchinson, the dicotyledon consists of 83 orders and 349 families, and monocotyledon consists of 29 orders and 60. So Merritt Hutchinson proposed the monocotyledon, monophytic origin of angiosperms, and some hypothetical pro-angiosperms having benignity and characteristics. He made a valuable contribution in the phylogenetic classification by his careful and critical studies. Monocots have been derived from dicots. According to him, the definition of orders and families are mostly precise, particularly in case of subphylum. So have some drawback, also some merits and demerits. So thank you very much for your kind attention.